Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Vidyasagar Mugi. Today we are going to calculate the quantity calculation of soak pit, which is one of the component of septic tank. So in the last part, you can check from the description, the link is given there, that we estimated the quantities for septic tank. So in general, septic tank and soak pit are provided together, but since I wanted you people to understand clearly what are the components involved in septic tank and soak pit, I have considered both the components and their estimation measurements to be calculated in the separate part, right? So in the last part we completed with the quantity calculation of septic tank. Today we'll look after soak pit. So soak pit, you can see from the figure, from the plan, soak pit is circular in shape. This is a cross-sectional elevation of the soak pit. So from the plan, if you see, the diameter of the soak pit is 100 cm, that is the internal one. Then it is provided by a series of layers. The first layer is the second class brickwork, which is made in 1:6 cement mortar. So likewise, there is a sand filling, brick aggregate and coarse sand filling, right? So if you see the cross-sectional elevation of the soak pit, from this is a ground level, from ground level this is 50 cm and this is 250 cm, so altogether it is 300 cm. I'll talk in terms of meters now. So from ground level till this point it is 3 meters. So diameter from ground level till 3 meter, it is different, and beyond that it is different. So all the thicknesses are given. So also we have a roof cover slab with the opening of 30 cm by 30 cm. So quickly we'll start with the quantity calculation of soak pit. The first quantity that I'm going to look is earthwork in excavation. You can see here soak pit up to depth of 3 meter and soak pit lower portion. So what I have done is I'm going to calculate the earthwork calculation in two different parts. The reason I have told you here that soak pit is of different diameters here. Up till 3 meter depth it is different diameter, and beyond that it is different diameters, right? So the earthwork calculation will be in two different parts. So just have a look here, soak pit up to 3 meter depth. So what is the diameter of soak pit up to 3 meter depth? It is, we'll start from the left hand side. This thickness is 15 15 15 30 30 plus 20 50. Similarly here this is 100, so from here to here it is how much? 150 150, plus this is 20 15 15. From this point to this point it is diameter is 2 meters. So here how we'll calculate this, so area into height, if I do, then I'll get the volume. So pi by 4 into 2 square, this is what, this is the area, into, if I multiply with the depth, what is the depth? Up till 3 meters, so I'll get this quantity. Then what is the diameter of the lower portion? Diameter of the lower portion is, see here, it is 20 plus 100 plus 20. So diameter of lower portion is 1.4 meter. So this is pi by 4 into 1.4 meter, and depth is what? 0.2. So all together, I'll write the direct quantity, you can calculate that. This is 19 meter cube. This is 19 meter cube. So we got the quantity for earthwork in excavation. Then moving on to next quantity. So here soak pit is made up of just a brickwork and sand. No cement concrete is involved except for that main wall. So that is what is main wall. So soak pit is generally constructed of second class brickwork in 1:6 cement mortar. So again we have divided this into upper portion and lower portion. So what is upper portion now? So upper portion is second class brickwork. So you can see from the figure here where he has mentioned second class brickwork. It is mentioned here. So brickwork with 1:6 cement mortar. He has shown the hatching. So here he is provided with brickwork with 1:6 cement mortar, and here he has provided with brickwork with 1:6 cement mortar. So this part and this part. What is the depth of this part? It is 20. What is the depth of this part? It is given here. It is 50. So how are you going to calculate this? Now you can see here, this brickwork is provided along the circumference, means inside part is hollow. So brickwork is not provided completely, it is only provided along the circumference. So to calculate the volume of this, you should know the perimeter of this, that is from center to center of this into the depth. So center to center of this is what? So I'll calculate this part. So this part is how much? This is 20. This is 20. Center of this is 20 by 2 is 10 plus 100 plus 20 by 2. So it is 120. So there is no brickwork in between. It is only along the periphery. You can see here. Then what I'll do is I'll calculate. I have got the center length. It is diameter of the center part. It is 1.2 meters. So perimeter is pi into 1.2. So upper portion is what? I'd write this as 1, 1. So this is pi into 1.2. What is the depth of upper portion? Depth of upper portion is 50 centimeter. So 50 centimeter is how much? It is 0.5. Similarly, bottom one, pi into 1.2. Depth is 0.2. Depth is 0.2. And thickness is what? 0.2. Thickness is 0.2. Thickness is 0.2. So you got the perimeter of center. And what is the thickness of brickwork? Brickwork thickness is 20 centimeter. Brickwork thickness is 20 centimeter into depth. You have to multiply with the depth. So the total quantity of this will come out to be 0.53 meter cube. So generally we don't carry out any deduction of brickwork in this particular part, because it will be initially constructed considering as a solid component. Later on, wherever the level of the piping comes, there they will cut open the brick part, right? So we don't consider any deduction here, right? So this is lower portion was this part. Now moving on to next quantity. So second class dry brickwork in soak pit. Now second class dry brickwork in soak pit, where is it provided? So this is the dry brickwork. You can see here he has written dry brickwork. So this has a part, straight lines are the dry brickwork. What is the height of them? It is 250 centimeter. They are also along the periphery, just below this brickwork. So what will be the perimeter of that? I'll write quantity 1. So this is also pi into 1.2 is the perimeter. What is the thickness? 0.2, and height is 2.5. so this quantity will come out to be 1.88 meter cube. Hope you followed these three parts. So any doubt with this, please feel free to ask. So for now, I'll only consider the three quantities, that is excavation, second class brickwork, second class dry brickwork. So next quantity, we'll take it in the next part. If you have any doubt with this, you please feel free to ask. Now you might be confused with how did I take pi into 1.2 here and why did I take pi by 4 into d square here. So let me tell you that part. Now this is the circular part of the soak pit, right? And if you see this, circular part. I'll just imagine this as a soak pit now. This is the ground level. When you are going to go for excavation of soil, are you only going to excavate this part like this, leaving soil here? No. When I say excavation, it is this complete volume. Means you are going to calculate or deduct, take out soil completely from this part. This complete soil is taken out. So complete soil is taken out means what? The area of this is what we calculated is a diameter. To calculate the area of this, we require diameter. So diameter was what? So area of circular part is calculated by what? Pi by 4 into d square. To take out the volume, I should multiply with what? I should multiply with h. That is what I did for excavation part. But when I calculate the brickwork, so bricks are not laid completely, they are like this. So this part is hollow, so bricks are laid like this, right? So bricks are laid like this means what? So if I take the elemental part, that is the elevation, so brickwork is carried out only up till like this. So if I take the cut section of this, brickwork is only like this. Right, so only bricks are provided here. So again, if you complete this like this. Right, so this is brickwork is provided here, but in between portion is hollow. So to calculate what is the brickwork along this part, so what should I require? I require center to center length from this part to this part. Right, so I require center to center length from here to here. So inner radius, we know that it was 100, thickness was 20, 20, so 10, 10 plus 100, 120. So what I did, I calculated the circumferential length. It was pi into 1.2 circumferential length. Then what was the thickness of this? For what thickness you are going to provide the brick? It is for thickness of 0.2. And for what height you are going to provide? You multiply that height. This is when you are providing brick lining. Remember this. When you are providing the bricks along the lining of the circle, then we use this. When you are calculating volume, it is area into depth. I hope you are clear with this. If any doubt, please feel free to ask. Thank you very much.